Om Shri Sai Ram, dear brothers and sisters, in the richness of Indian tradition, the Guru is hailed as the dispeller of darkness and worship through various sutras and songs. We, the students of the institute and school, take this opportunity on the holy occasion of Gurupoornima to humbly place a bouquet of the choicest selections from various Sanskrit hymns and songs at the feet of our Sadguru, God Himself, from whom all music and wisdom flows. And we offer all our art along with our heart. Om Sri Sai Ram. On this auspicious occasion of Gurupoornima, Swami has graciously consented to inaugurate the protected water supply schemes which are now under execution around the whole district. One has also desired that we request Sri Kondal Rao, who is amidst us today, to give us a brief idea of the scope of the Sri Sathya Sai water supply project. Sri Kondal Rao has been the engineer-in-chief of Panchayat Raj Department of the Gram Sabha of the nation and is currently secretary to the Gram Sabha of the nation, the Department of Panchayat Raj. He is also designated as a technical advisor to Sri Sathya Sai water supply project, and concurrently he called the commissioner for special project funded by World Bank and Dutch Garden for the state of our state. I now take pleasure in requesting Sri Kondal Rao to come and talk to us. Sri Kondal Rao. Bhagawan is giving the water of life to so many people in various villages of Anantapur district today. As most of you may be aware, Bhagawan had, during the birthday celebrations in November 94, graciously agreed to provide funds for drinking water supply schemes. He also said that the government should address themselves to the need to provide safe drinking water to all the villages in Rayalaseema area, as this area suffers from periodic droughts. Later, when Bhagawan expressed his resolve to provide adequate funds for drinking water schemes in Anantapur district, which have already been formulated and kept ready for execution, we came here and submitted such schemes. Bhagawan gave us the guidelines that we should come up with long-term solutions for the scarcity and fluoride-affected villages. Bhagawan also said that we should convey water through pipes from reliable sources so that safe drinking water will be available throughout the year. In accordance with the guidelines, we reviewed our proposals and submitted different types of schemes. Broadly speaking, they include the following: direct pumping of water from Penna Ahodilam Barracks and Reservoir after treatment, pumping water from infiltration wells on the river beds of the Chakaravarthi Barracks and Reservoir at Parnapalli, pumping water from other infiltration wells on the Penna and Hagri river beds at various places in the district, pumping water from the Tungabhadra high level canal when water flows in the canal for about 5 to 6 months in a year, and store it in summer storage tanks so that water can be supplied throughout the year from such storage tanks after treatment. Where water from Tungabhadra high level canal or Balance and Reservoir or any other river cannot be conveyed, we have resorted to subsurface water through bore wells. The direct pumping from Penna Ahodilam Reservoir will provide water throughout the year to large number of villages, mainly in Kalyanpur, Arthampur and Kambari villages of the district. Similarly, the infiltration wells in Chitravati Balancing Reservoir will provide water for a large number of villages in Chitrupa, Kadiri, Kadimari, Dharmarwaram, Puch, are chronically suffering from high chlorine incidence. The infiltration wells at Vamadi will meet the needs of Kutti town. Other infiltration wells in different places such as Kallur, Kondur and Tadpatni on Penna River will provide water in Kutti and Tadpatni mandals. There are also infiltration wells in Hagani River bed which will provide water to villages in Kalyanadu and Rayadurg areas of the district. There are 7 summer storage tanks forming part of the Sathya Sai water supply project. These tanks vary in size from 30 acres to about 100 acres and are located at Anantapur town and other places such as Vanakandla, B. Papur, Vidapankal, Gadekal and Gudsarapalli. These tanks will provide water for Anantapur town and various villages. The construction of all these tanks has almost been completed and it should be possible to lay pipes and make them functional by October of this year. It is the chief merit of all these schemes that they will provide clean, pure and fluoride-free water throughout the year, that is for all 365 days a year. The total length of the pipes to be laid of various sizes ranging from 600 millimeters to 80 millimeters diameter. Under these schemes will be more than 2,500 kilometers. It is indeed a massive work and Bhagawan's directive is that they must all be completed and commissioned before November. The total period available for execution of these schemes is hardly 8 months as work was started only in March of this year. I dare say that no one except Bhagawan can undertake such a task. Conventional organizations will take at least 3 years to complete all these works and here Bhagawan has given not even a year. Given his grace and blessings, there is nothing impossible. His will would certainly be done. It has indeed been heartening to see that from the word go, work has been progressing at good speed. I would like to mention here that there has been very close coordination of all the agencies involved in this project, namely the Sathya Sai Central Trust, the Government of Andhra Pradesh and the Larsen & Toubro who has been designated as the prime agency. This is because of identity of interest and due to the inspiration and encouragement given by Bhagawan to all of us. I would like to express my grateful thanks to Bhagawan on my own behalf and on behalf of the Government of Andhra Pradesh for having so generously come forward to provide drinking water to a chronically drought-affected area of Andhra Pradesh. Before I formally pray to Bhagawan to inaugurate the project water supply scheme today, I would like to say that this is a unique project with substantial outlay covering more number of villages in this district, the like of which has not been attempted anywhere else in the country by any other organization or trust. For the inauguration of the scheme, we have provided for remote control button operating on VHF. When the button is pressed here, the pump and motor at Mukhavatnam village will get activated and water will flow into the pump line. There is also a model of the protected water supply scheme kept here to be lighted as a symbolic inauguration of the scheme in various other villages in the district. May I, on behalf of all those devotees assembled here now, pray to Bhagawan to inaugurate the protected water supply scheme which will provide safe water to various villages in the district by lighting the lamp and switching on the button. Om Jai Ram. connection to my previous announcement. Bhagawan will be giving his divine message here at 4 p.m. at Sai Kulwant Hall. Thank you. Sai Ram.